Let us pay homage to the Buddha by reciting Namo Tassa three times. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. In this rain retreat, 3 months, I was teaching the Patana. I'm there in the Vasa, the Pumon day, so we can chanting. The Buddha teaching many Dhamma talks. 84,000 of the Dhamma talk. They are divided into the three categories called three baskets. They are Vinaya, monastic code, Sotanda Vinaya, doctrinal teaching, and Abhidhamma Vidaka, higher teaching. Abhidhamma, as the name suggests, a highly respected and considered more profound than the other two. The Buddha is teaching the higher doctrine Abhidhamma to his mother, who is now a deva. And other beings in Dawa Densa heaven.
孙子说呢，在这即将来临的这，就是在现在这个3个月的与安居期间，孙子将会我们教导这个 Patana 这个24缘，一直到呢与安居结束。那在与安居结束的月圆日呢，我们就可以在圆满学习这个 Patana 之后呢，大家可以一起念诵这个 Patana。
What is Abhidhamma? Abhidhamma, this word is composed of two parts, Abhi and Dhamma. Abhi means excellent or higher. Dhamma means teaching or doctrine, which means excellent teaching or higher doctrine.
Bhante, I translate earlier, Bhante mentioned about the three baskets. Mm-hmm. 佛陀呢在教导了有84,000法蕴，那其中呢可以分成三藏，那即是呢Vinaya 就是律藏，Suddhanta 净藏，以及阿比达摩就是律藏论藏。那在阿比达摩里面呢就是更高的这个教法。那之前呢我们看到一张图呢，就是佛陀在33天为他已经成为天子的母亲以及其他天人呢讲述阿比达摩。那接下去呢尊者说阿比达摩是什么意思呢？阿比达摩就是由这两个阿比跟达玛这两个字组合的，这意思呢就是更高或者更殊胜的教法。 OK 的。
The omission Buddha expounded the 7 books of the Abhidhamma higher doctrine in the Dawa Densa world of the Deva, namely the Dhamma Sangani, Illumination of States, Vibhanga, Book of Classification, Dhadu Gatha, Discourse on Element, Bogala Pinyati, Designation of Individuals, Gatha Vatu, Point of Controversy, Yamaka, Book of Prayers in Patana, Conditional Relation successively. Of these 7 books Abhidhamma, the last one, Patana. Patana is decidedly the most profound the subtle and difficult to understand. For this reason, it is also called the great book Mahabharata and a complete book with a finite method, Ananda Naya Bhatana, Ananda Naya Samanda Bhatana.
一切知之的佛陀在一生中呢教导了有这七部的阿毗达摩的论，那这七部呢分别就是第一部的法集论，第二的分别论，第三戒论，第四是人事摄，第五呢是论事，第六双论，以及第七这个 Patana、这个 Patana 呢在这七部论里面呢是最深奥最微妙最难懂的，因此呢 Patana 呢也被称为Mahabharata 大论，或者是呢也称为 Ananta Naya Samatha Bhatana， 就是呢拥有不可计量的很多的不同的方法呢完整的这样的一部 Bhatana。 OK 的、
In terms of Bhatana, Pali is compound of the prefix Pas and Tana.Past means variate and Tana means cause or condition, which means various cause or various condition. Really, even each of 24, such as root condition, hetu, pachaya, so on, possesses various causes. So each condition is called Patana.
那关于 Patana 这个字呢、这个词是由两个部分组成，就是前缀 Pa 以及、它 Tana 这个字。那 Pa 呢的意思呢就是指各种各样的各式各样的，然后 Tana 呢是指因或者是缘。那这样呢组合起来呢就是说呢 Patana 指的就是有各种的因缘。那的确的呢我们在这 Patana 里面学到的24缘呢，每一种缘譬如说这个因缘等等呢都拥有许许多多的因，许许多的缘法，因此呢，每一个缘都可以称为 Patana。 明白吗？
The benefits of contemplating and reciting Patana. The contemplating and reciting Patana, one could at any time attain the following benefits. They are overcoming all the dangers.Anxieties, worries, and suffering that he faces him. Escaping from all the dangers that befell on him. Accomplishing all the moral actions which are faultless and produce good results.
通过思维以及念诵 Patana 呢可以获得以下的种种的利益。那首先呢能够克服所面对的一切危险灾难，一切的焦虑担忧以及苦痛。然后呢如果有危险降临一个人的话，也能够因此呢从这些危险中脱离，也可以帮助这样的一个人呢可以完成一切可以带来好的果报的善业。
refraining from committing all the immoral actions which are faulty and produce bad results. Accomplishing all good works that he is doing. Realizing Nibbana in this last existence.
那还有其他的利益呢，就是可以远离一切会可以带来不好的不可依的果报的恶业，然后呢也可以帮助圆满正在进行的一切的三行，然后呢可以在最后一世呢证悟涅槃。
These are the benefits of contemplating and reciting Patana. Nowadays, many people reciting this Patana, they would got the benefits.
那以上呢就是种种呢通过念诵 Patana 可以得到的利益。现在有许多人也在每天有在念诵这个 Patana， 他们呢也可以得到这样的这些利益。
After the Buddha enlightenment, the Buddha stay in seven places. They are number one, the weak on the throne, Palinga Sataha. Number two, the wheat on the kese, Animita Sataha. Number three, the wheat on the walk, Sankama Sataha. Number four, the wheat at the golden house, Yatana Gaha Sataha.
当我们的佛陀在觉悟成佛之后呢，他一共呢在七个地方呢停留了各停留了七天。那首先呢第一个星期呢是在菩提座或者金刚座那边停留了七天，然后接下去呢不眨眼的就是说的在一个地方呢注视不眨眼的注视呢七天，然后进行七天，然后第四个星期呢在宝物七天。
Number five, the wheat at the Ajabala beyond tree, Ajabala Sadaha. Number six, the wheat at the Monchalinda Lake, Monchalinda Sadaha. Number seven, the wheat at the Raja Yatana tree, Raja Yatana Sadaha, to the 49 days.
然后接下去第五个星期呢，佛陀在这个阿迦帕拉榕树逗留了七天，然后第六个星期在穆恰林达湖逗留了七天，然后呢最后一个星期呢在这个拉加亚特纳树的那树下呢逗留了七天，所以总共呢七七49天。
The first week on the throneAfter enlightenment, Buddha spent the past week under the Bodhi tree, experiencing the bliss of arahantship.
佛陀在觉悟后的第一个星期呢，在菩提树下停留了一个星期，在体验着阿拉汉果的了。
The second week of the kese.Animita Sadaha. The Buddha spent the second week gazing at the Bodhi tree in gratitude with unbreaking eyes. Animita Loka Sana Chediya, showing here marks at the exact spot later I will show. So when you go in the Buddha here, you can see.
然后在第二个星期呢，佛陀以感恩心，不眨眼的凝视着菩提树。那他佛陀当时所站的地方呢，现在我们可以看到在图中呢，就以这一座阿尼米萨罗恰呢，就是这个不眨眼的揭谛，来标记着当时呢佛陀所处的这个位置。以站在这个位置呢。以感恩心不眨眼的凝视着菩提树一个星期。
The Chediya inside had the Buddha. So the Buddha, the second week, when after enlightenment, so he sit down there, this Chediya place, and look to the Bodhi tree in the throne, and breaking eyes about 7 days, never moving, never.Go out everywhere continuously.
甚至说我们现在去到菩提迦耶呢，也可以看到这一座塔。那当时呢，佛陀就是在这一座塔里面坐在这边呢，凝视着菩提树，凝视着金刚座，不眨眼睛的，在一个星期的时间呢，没有移动，没有去任何地方，就只是不眨眼睛的凝视着菩提树与金刚座。
The third week on the walk. The Buddha spent the third week in walking meditation along a closer called Chenkama beside the Bodhi tree. and concrete Brahpao now at the marks that site. You can see when you visit to the Bodh Gaya.
而在第三个星期的时候呢，佛陀就用了七天的时间在进行。那进行的这个地方呢，就是在现在呢，我们去到菩提迦耶呢，也可以看得见。那布盖亚可以看得见这样的这样的一座以混凝土的平台来标记的地方，在这边呢，佛陀进行了七天。
So when you visit to the Bodh Gaya, you can see many concrete Brahpao like this.So this is after Buddha enlightenment, the Takui. So he walked in meditation about 1 week. Never lying down.
甚至说现在如果我们去到这个菩提迦耶，这个波迦亚呢，我们可以看到这样的一个混凝土的这个平台。那这个就是当时呢，佛陀在觉悟后的第三个星期。在这个地方呢，来回的进行一个星期，也没有躺卧下来，就一直的不停的进行七天。
On the third week, the Buddha spent the 7 days walking up and down on the Tiwa walk, created by Tiwas and Brahma, and stretching from east to west between the Apalachika throne and.The Jidia of the Kasi. So why at the same time he was reflecting on the Dhamma and getting absorbed in the Parasamapati? Meditating on the Prussian Arham attainment, that place is called Yadana Sankhama Jidia.
在第三个星期的时候呢，佛陀用了七天的时间，就在这个宝石进行这个地方呢进行。那这个呢是天人以及梵天中呢所造的这个进行道从东到西，处于呢就是菩提树下金刚座跟第二个星期的这个不眨眼的地方的那个塔呢之间。那这个由东到西在这两座金刚座跟不眨眼塔之间的这样的这个进行道。佛陀当时呢，一边进行，一边思维法义，并且呢，进入了果定，所以这个地方呢，就成为了宝石进行塔，宝石进行结壁。
The porch of the golden house. The Buddha spent the porch in the Yadanagaha golden house, reflecting on the Abhidhamma.So now coming, where the Buddha practicing the Abhidhamma. So as he contemplated on it deep in profound doctrine, there arose great rapture in his omniscient mind, which causes the body to emit kara rays, 6 kara rays.
第四个星期的时候呢，佛陀就在宝屋里面呢，去思维阿毗达摩的深奥法义。甚至说呢，现在呢，我们就来到了，知道呢，佛陀当时呢是在什么地方去思维这个阿毗达摩的深奥法义。那由于佛陀在思维这个阿毗达摩的深奥法义，所以呢，心里面升起非常强烈的喜，乃至于呢，在他的一切知之的这个心里面呢。升起了非常强烈这个喜，导致身体发出了这个光芒。
The rays emitted from the body of the Buddha. On the day, he contemplated the doctrine of Patana. Those rays are still moving towards the countless world system, even today as continuous changing of the temperature, bone, kalapa.Uduja Rupa.
当佛陀在思维这个 Patana 法义的那一天呢，从他的身上散发出来的这些光芒，一直到今天还持续不断的以一系列的这个十劫声色 Uduja Rupa 的形式呢，一直不断的呢，这个光芒还是朝向无数的这个轮回世界继续的扩展开来。
So the Buddha represents Abhidhamma. Before this, empty six Abhidhamma, the Buddha, the Bodhinoya, come out the race. After he reflecting, contemplating the doctrine of the Abhatthana, that time from the Buddha body come out the six ray. The ray is coming out from the body and going to the water system, counterlight water system. Even today also still have not yet disappearing. It's changing the temperature bone color bar by temperature bone color bar, so continuously.
当佛陀在视为前面六部的阿比达摩的法衣的时候呢，他身上并没有发出光芒。一直到佛陀在视为第七部的这个帕塔纳的这个圣奥法衣的时候呢，就从佛陀的身上散发出这六色的光芒。那从佛陀的 身上呢散发出来，一直呢往无数的这个轮回世界呢一直这样的扩展开去。那即使到了今天呢，这么久的以后呢，这样的光芒呢还没有消失，还是一直去持续不断的以一代又一代的时节声色的方式呢继续的散发出去。
The Buddha spent the 5 weeks at the Acabala Niyodha Tree.Bodas beyond. The site is located at the bottom of the staircase as one enters the Mahabodhi Temple in Bodh Gaya. The Buddha proceeded to the foot of Acabala beyond tree, saturated to the each of the Mahabodhi tree in stay.For 7 full days at the foot of the tree, reflecting on the Dhamma and Asop in plasma body. The beyond tree was called Acabala because of it was there that Gautama together. Acabala Nirodha, the beyond tree under the shape of which Gautama.Took shade.
在第五个星期的时候呢，佛陀就在这个 Acabala Nirodha， 就是牧羊者榕树下，或者叫做Acabala 榕树或者牧羊者榕树下呢度过。那这个地方呢，在今天的 Buddha Gaya 呢，就是当我们进入 Buddha Gaya 呢，在这个 Mahabodhi 就是摩诃菩提寺的入口处呢，有一个楼梯，在楼梯的台阶的底部呢，就是这个牧羊者榕树的位置。那当时呢，佛陀在第五个星期呢，就去到了这个属于位置处于摩诃菩提寺，就是马哈菩提寺的东部的这个榕树的下面，在那边呢停留了7天，在那边视为佛法以及进入果定。那为什么这个榕树称为 Acabala 牧羊者榕树呢？是因为有一群牧羊者呢经常在那里聚集，所以因此呢这个树就叫做 Acabala Nirodha， 就是牧羊者榕树，因为呢牧羊者在盖榕树的树荫下聚集，所以称为牧羊者榕树。
The Buddha spent 6 weeks meditating at the Monchalinda tree. The Buddha spent the 7 days sitting cross-legged and enjoying theBliss of Arahantship. At that time, a great rainstorm arose and the serpent came out the lake. Monchalinda protected the Buddha by coiling around his body using his hood to cover the Buddha's head. When the heavy rain came, a strong Naga king named Monchalinda, who rules the Naga abode under the lake, thought the rain fell when the Buddha took shelter in my house. It would be good to find a dwelling place for him. The Naga king could create a grand mansion with seven queens of Jiwa by himself. But he decided it would not be much benefit to offer a Jiwa mansion to the Buddha. I will serve him with my body. So he transported into a huge snake coin around the Buddha seven times and covered his head with his hood, protecting Buddha from the cold, heat, gnats, mosquito, flies, and so on.
在第六个星期的时候呢，佛陀就在这个 Mucchalinda 树下度过。那当时呢，佛陀用了七天的时间呢，盘腿而坐，在享受这个阿拉汉果的快乐。那个时候呢，就升起了 一场大的暴风雨。那当时呢，在湖中的这个蛇王或者龙王呢 ，Mucchalinda 就以他的身体围绕着佛陀以他的这个背部，他的这个眼罩或者叫兜帽来保护着佛陀的头部。因为当时呢，当下起这个大暴风雨的时候呢，这个非常强有力的这个龙王 Mucchalinda 呢，他就这么想，他当时呢就是属于龙宫，就是在这个湖底的龙宫的统治者，所以他看到这个大风雨的时候，他心里面就这么想，他说这个非季节性的大雨，在佛陀一来到我住的地方呢，就降临了，就下起了这样的一场大风雨。如果我能够为佛陀提供一个庇护所，一个住所呢，那会很好。那这个龙王呢，因为他很有力量，他可以自己呢变现一座七宝装饰的大宫殿。可是他心里面这么想，如果我只是变现一座七宝宫殿来供养给佛陀，这并不能带来非常殊胜的大利益。因此呢，他决定要以他的身体来亲自为佛陀服务，所以他将他身体变得非常的庞大，以他的身体盘绕着佛陀七圈，并且呢，将他头部两旁的这个兜帽眼罩把它扩展开来，用来遮盖着佛陀的头部，使到佛陀不会受到冷、热、盲、蚊、飞虫等种种的伤害与干扰。
At the time, the Naga protected the Buddha. Here you see the picture, not like this.The Buddha image might put inside the coin. So after that, he put in the heat like this. So the rain and the prying or the cold or hot not disturb to the Buddha. Buddha can continue practicing. After that rain stops, the King Naga, he changing like the human. After that, he pay bow down to the Buddha.Three times.
那当时候呢，这个龙王呢在保护着佛陀。那其实我们看到这个图里面呢，当时的情况并不是这样的，因为我们这边看到呢，佛陀的这个身体呢是在这个龙或者这个蛇呢这个盘绕上面，它其实呢佛陀的身体呢是要被这个蛇呢以他的身体呢围绕住来保护着的。只剩下头部呢也有它的这个扩展开来的这个兜帽呢也把它遮挡住，所以因此呢整个佛陀呢都很好的被这个Mucchalinda蛇王所保护着，因此呢不会受到这种热冷这种种的这些干扰，佛陀呢可以继续在里面呢禅修。当雨停了之后呢，这个龙王呢就变现成为人的身体，然后呢顶礼佛陀三次。
The Buddha spent the 7 weeks at the Rajayatana Tree, where two machine brothers, Taposa and Balika, offer him honey in rice cakes. After that, they took two refuges by reciting Iti Mayambandi Bhagavandan Saranang Gacchama Dhammencha. It means Bhagavandan Saranang Gacchami Dhamman Saranang Gacchami. We refrain him. So these two were the first Bodhis in whom the two world refuges were established.
在第七个星期的时候呢，佛陀在这个 Rajayatana 树下呢度过。在这时候呢，有两位三人兄弟呢，叫做 Tapusa 以及 Balika， 他们来到这里呢，供养佛陀蜜糖和米糕。然后供养之后呢，他们就跟佛陀呢进行二皈依不是三皈，是二皈依。然后他们将这念诵的内容就是说，尊者，我们前往皈依 Bhagava 以及法，所以呢，他们就是等于说呢，是念这个我皈依佛，我皈依法这两种二皈依，所以他们呢是这两位呢是最早进行二皈依的在家弟子。
According to commentary say, these two brother Tapusa and Balika, they are from Myanmar, so they came to do some business.So at that time, one of Deva passed like they are friends. They agreement something. So after that, the Deva reminded to them, there is a Buddha stay. You're going to offer something. So that's why these two brothers, Tapusa and Balika, they're going to see and pay bound down to the Buddha, and they offer the rice and honey cakes.So after that, so the Buddha kept to then only two refuges. That I know yet the Sangha. The early, late Bodhis. After that, they request to the Buddha. Buddha, when we went back to our country, so we need to refuse any concept. So the Buddha used the right hand and touch the head, come out there the Buddha hair.Keep to them. They bring back to the Myanmar. Now and they, the Sri Dagong Pagoda inside the. So we cannot see the Buddha here because of underground, very protected. Inside a lot of the machine, like automatically many arrow or many the aim appliance, we cannot go in. That's why we cannot see.At the underground, under the Sri Dagong Pagoda.
那根据译注的记载呢，这两位上人兄弟 Tapusa 跟 Balika 呢是从缅甸过去的。当时呢，他们到了印度去做一些生意。那当时他们在过去世的一个朋友，当时呢是一位天人。他们过去是曾经有过一个约定，因此呢，这个天人呢就来提醒他们说，现在呢佛陀已经出现于世了，你们赶快前去供养。那因此呢，这两位兄弟呢就去见了佛陀，顶礼了佛陀，然后呢供养佛陀这个蜜糖和米糕，然后呢佛陀就给予他们这二皈依。那只有二皈依，为什么呢？因为当时呢还没有僧团，所以不能进行三皈依，所以只能进行二皈依。这个呢，这两位上人兄弟呢就是教法里面最早的在家弟子。那过后呢，他们就跟佛陀请求说，那佛陀，当我们回到我们的国家的时候，我们能够以什么来纪念佛陀您呢？那当时佛陀呢就从他头上呢拿了一些头发，然后把这头发给了这两位兄弟。这两位上人兄弟就把佛陀的头发带回了缅甸。那现在呢，这些头发呢就是藏在在仰光的 Shade God， 就是大金塔的底下。那我们一般人我们不能够看得见，因为呢它是藏在大金塔的地底下，而且呢里面呢有许多的不同的这个机械的这个机器呢在保护着它，有剑啊等等呢来防止不要让别人去偷走这样的意思。所以呢，因此呢我们没有看得见，不过呢这佛陀的头发呢现在呢是在这个大金塔式的底层的地底下。
when you go into the India, so you must pay respect to these seven places. The Bodhi tree, do you know where is the Buddha practicing Abhidhamma? This place. So this place is a Buddha practicing Abhidhamma. Repracting Abhidhamma. So now you can see this mark or the body kaya. So there also you can see again. So like this, the 7 week.
尊者说呢，如果今天我们去到了印度呢，我们去朝圣的时候呢，我们需要再去布迪盖亚呢，菩提迦耶这边呢去顶礼这七个地方，包括呢就是菩提树，以及特别呢就是佛陀在第四个星期呢，在宝物那边四维阿毗达摩的这个地方，那我们可以看到这个图里面呢，这个就是这个布迪盖亚的这个马哈菩提寺院的这个地图，我们可以看到当时呢佛陀在觉悟后的七个星期所处的七个不同的地方。
The 7 weeks, the Buddha repracting the Abhidhamma, so his body become this real, the light, colorful, the types of real lights that come out from his body.
那在第四个星期，佛陀在四维阿毗达摩的圣道法仪的时候呢，就从佛陀的身上呢散发出这六色光芒。
And the omission Buddha expounded the 7 books of the Abhidhamma, higher doctrine, in the Tower Densa wall of the Deva, namely, do you remember? The Dhammasangini, Illumination of the State, Vibhanga, Book of Classification, Dhadugatha, Discourse on Elements, Pogalapinyadi, Designation of Individuals, Gatavotu, White of Controversy, Yamaka, Book of Pair and Patana, Conditional Relation, Successively. On the 7 book of the Abhidhamma, the last one is Patana. Patana is decidedly the most profound, subtle, and difficult to understand. If you don't know how to read, how to learn. For this reason, it is also called the great book and a complete book with an infinite method, Ananda Naya Samanda Patana.
一切智智的佛陀呢，他就在33天，为天人们呢宣说了这七部阿毗达摩的论。那尊者们说，我们还记得吗？刚才讲过的，那分别呢就是第一部法集，第二是分别，第三是戒论，第四是人事色，第五是论事，第六是双论，以及第七部的这个帕塔纳，就是这样依序的一步一步的这样在33天宣说。那在这七部阿毗达摩里面呢，最后一部呢，帕塔纳呢是最深奥、微妙、难懂的。尊者说呢，如果我们不懂得如何去读、如何去学习的话呢，它将会是很难、很深奥的。那因为这个原因呢，它就称为大论，也称为呢拥有不可计量的方法的这样的一部完整的帕塔纳。
You can learn the Yamaka book of prayer, also very good. So you can understand the Dhamma more profound also. In Myanmar, many Pali school, they teaching with a method, so technique, so we can learn very easy. If we are without technique, not easy to learn the Abhidhamma.
甚至说呢， 我们如果可以学习这第六部 Yamaka 算论也很好，因为呢，我们是能够更好的去理解这个佛法。在缅甸的这些教导巴黎的这些学校里面呢，都会教导呢一些方法，特别的方法呢来学习这些阿毗达摩。有了这些方法呢，那就很容易的可以学习。如果没有这些三巧的方法呢，那我们学习起来呢就会很吃力。
The term of Patana. The Patana Pali is composed of the replaced past and Tana. Past means barriers, Tana means cause of doctrine, which means condition, cause of condition, which means barrier cause or barrier condition. Really, even each of 24 such as root condition, Hedu Bachayo, Aramana Bachayo, etc., possesses various causes. So each condition is called Patana. In its absolute sense, Patana is a conditional relation. That is the relation between the conditioning state and the conditioned state. Bachayo Panna Dhamma.
这个 Patana 这个词呢，是由两个部分组合而成。那前面呢有一个前缀，就是个 Pa 的意思就是各式各样的、各种各样的。然后后面呢 Tana 指的就是因或者是缘。所以结合起来，这个 Patana 这个词呢的意思就是有种种的这个因缘。那的确呢，我们在学习到的这24缘里面，比如说呢，因缘、所缘缘这些呢缘呢，每一种缘呢都有许许多多的这个缘法。那因此呢，每一种缘呢都可以称为 Patana。在究竟义来说呢， Patana 就是指缘法，就是这个因跟缘生法这个果呢之间的这个关系啊。所以这个缘法跟缘生法之间的关系呢，就是这边Patana 所要教导的。
So when you learn the Patana, you need to know this tree. So slowly, slowly, you will understand it. Conditioning state, Pichaya Dhamma, is referred to the attract cause. Conditioned state, Pichaya Upanna Dhamma, is referred to the attract effect. And conditioned force, Pichaya Sati.
当我们在学习这个 Patana 的时候呢，我们需要对这三个名词哦，这有很充分的、很好的了解。那慢慢的呢，甚至说我们就会理解的更深。那这边呢，首先第一个呢叫做 Pachaya Dhamma， 就是缘法，缘法指的就是因。然后呢，Pachaya Upanna Dhamma 就是指的是缘生法呢，是指的是果。然后 Pachaya Sati 呢，就是指因跟果这个缘法跟缘生法之间呢。这个关系，这个原理。
Conditioning states, Vichaya Dhamma. It is the state which is the cause on which the effect is dependent. It is the cause that is related to an effect, without which there can be.No effort. That's great. It's according a condition, a condition state of root condition. And a visible object based on a conditioned state of the object condition.
然后首先呢，这个 Pachaya Dhamma 指的是缘法，它就是指呢因啊，那就是呢。果法能够升起呢，必须要依赖的这个因就是叫做缘法。缘法是与果呢有密切的关系的。如果没有了这个缘法，没有这个因的话，就不会升起这个果。那因此呢，举例子说呢，在 Hedu Pachaya 就是因缘里面呢，贪就是它的缘法，它的因。然后呢，所缘缘里面呢， 依着颜色所缘呢，就是属于它的缘法。
Condition state, it is the state which is the effect that result from a cause. It is the effect which is related by a cause. That's in the example of the relation given about I conditions element and its associated state are the conditioned state of the object condition.
那接下去呢，我们学习这个Paccayupanna Dhamma 呢，就是缘生法。这个缘生法呢，就是指果，就是由于刚才的因而带来的这样的一种果，那这个叫做缘生法。那我如果我们根据上面所给过的例子，那在所缘缘里面呢，颜色所缘是因，那它的果呢就是眼识界，以及呢跟它相应的住法，这些呢就是属于所缘缘的缘生法。
Causal conditioned is the power that makes things happen. It is like the heat in chili or the sweet in sugar, which cannot exist without them. Similarly, conditioned forces in our feeling or mental states are inseparable from those states. For example, greed is the root condition. And the force of greed is also greed itself. We must remember that a state can have many conditioned forces, such as non-delusion, predominance, connections, and more. These forces and the state they belong to are closely connected and cannot be separated from each other.
接下来这个原力呢，原力指的就是这种力量能够让果法升起，就是这样的一种力量呢，就叫做原力。那举一个例子说呢，就好像辣椒里面有这个辛辣的这个辣性，糖里面呢有这个甜的味道，那这些呢辣或者是甜味呢，这些都不能够跟辣椒或糖呢分开，它们必须跟辣椒跟糖呢是一起存在的。那同样的，我们的这些讲的这些原理呢，不管是我们的各种明法里面的原理啊，我们的感受等等的原理呢，是不能跟这些明法分开的，它们是密不可分的。举例子说呢，贪是因缘的缘法，贪的原理呢，也就是贪本身，所以这个贪呢，同时是因缘的缘法，也是这个因缘的原理，所以它是不能够分开的。但是我们要知道，一个法呢，可以有多过一种原理，可以有不同的原理。那举例子说呢，无痴或者是我们讲的智慧，这个慧根呢，无痴呢，它可以同时具有应缘的原理、增上缘的原理、聚胜缘的原理等等许多的原理。但是这些原理呢，无论如何呢，都是跟他们所属的这个缘法呢，是密切相连，不可能分开来的。
When you are practicing Patana, the main is this Pachyasati condition force. If you don't know cause and effect, you know you're practicing depending.Origination, you cannot understand it. Because this is not only cause and effect. So condition force is a main meditation object for Patana.
甚至说当我们在实修这个 Patana 的时候呢，最主要的就是在于这个原理的这一方面。因为如果我们之前还没有了解因与果，没有去学习，没有去理解这个缘起的话呢，我们就没有办法去理解这个原理。因为在我们在实修 Patana 的时候，不只是要知道因跟果，更重要的呢是要知道他们之间的这个原理，这个才是真正的要实修 Patana 里面的范围的内容呢，是在于这个原理。
The chili very spicy. The spicy is the conditioned food, vichyasati. The sugar, very sweet. You cannot spray out. So in the same way, when you practice in the patana, for example, if you become angry, not only angry mind, with associated mental fetter. Not only mental fetter, mind bone kalaba also. So there is a, you see, dosa, we call dosa, hatred. After that, 16 or 17 mental fetter in mind bone kalaba. So you see the dosa in the mind in mental fetter, mind in mental fetter, and mind bone kalaba. At the time, you can see not only the root condition, there's a condition force. So together, at the time, the mind and the mental fetter always together, so sahajata. They are all the time dependent. Also, mind also had those angry mind, mental fetter and mind bone kalaba also have so at T, cannot separate out there. Appear at the same time. So that's why avikata condition also included. So this is a condition pose, not only the hetu.
那举例说呢，比如说辣椒，辣椒呢是非常辣的，这个很辣的，这个特性呢，就是属于这个原力的一种譬喻。那糖呢是很甜的，这个甜呢，也就是譬喻成这个原力。这个原力呢，辣或者是甜呢都不可以跟辣椒或这个糖果呢分离出来，所以原力呢是不可以跟它的这个缘法分离出来的。那如果我们在实修的这个帕塔纳的时候呢，举例子说，我们如果生气了这个时候，那不只是呢心里面升起这个多萨，升起这个嗔恨、嗔恚啊，那同时呢与嗔恚同时升起的还有与它相应的这些心所。 那可能是16或者17个相应的心所，那不只是有相应的心所，还会有这个心生色聚呢，也会一起呢升起。所以呢，到这个时候呢，在实修的帕塔那时候，就需要去能够去辨识、去观察到这个嗔与它的相应心所，还有这些心生色聚之间的这个缘的这个关系、这个缘力。所以这时候， 我们可以实修的时候去观察它，它不只是有这个因缘的缘力，同时呢，由于这个心跟心所是同时升起的，所以它们呢也有俱生缘的缘力，它们是互相依止的，也有依止缘的缘力。那这个嗔这个心所呢，跟它的相应心所，还有一些心生色聚呢，它们是同时都是存在的，所以呢也有这个有缘的缘力，也有不离去缘的缘力。 所以呢，我们可以从这样的实修去看到，它不只是只有单单一种因缘的原理，还有呢，其他的许多的原理。
Now going on instruction of Patana. Patana is made up of two main chapter, called Pali Vara. The brief chapter, Madhika Nikheva Vara, and the great chapter, Mahavara. So the brief chapter consisted of two chapters. The enumeration of condition, Pichaya Pichodesa Vara, and the analytical exposition of the condition, Pichaya Nidesa Vara. In the illumination of the condition, each of the 24 conditions, it is enumerated starting with root condition, Hetu Bachaya, Aramana Bachaya, and addendum with non-disappearing condition, Avikata Bachaya, as shown in future. So in the analytical exposition of the condition, given a brief account of their condition and the conditioned state of each of the 24 conditions. It starts with root condition, Hetu Paccaya, and then with the Avigata Paccaya.
接下去呢，尊者将为我们解释这个 Patana 的这个结构。那 Patana 呢是由两个很大的这个部分，这个 Vara 这个分组成的。那首先呢，一个呢是叫做Matika Nikepa Vara， 就是论母的这个略分。然后呢，另外一个呢就是 Mahavara， 就是大分，这两个部分组成。那这个略分呢有两个章节。那首先呢就是这个Paccaya Udesa， 就是原种说。那原种说呢就是将这24种缘呢把它列出来，那顺序的从一开始的这个 Hetu Paccaya 因缘呢，一直呢到最后的 Avigata Paccaya 不离去缘。然后另外一个呢，另外一个章节呢是原广说。原广说呢就是呢很概要的去阐述这24个缘，他们个别的缘法以及缘生法，他们也是从这个因缘事这边开始呢，一直到呢以不离去缘为缘这样的来结束。
So this rain retreat was a, we can learn only brief chapter. We cannot learn the great chapter. Brief chapter illumination of the condition, Paccaya Udesa andanalytical exploration of condition, Paccaya Nidesa Vara.
尊者说呢，在这个与安居呢，尊者只能够教导我们这个略分的这个内容，就是原总说以及原广说的内容，没有办法在这个与安居呢期间去教导我们关于大分里面的内容。
The great chapter.Start with the question, depending on moral dhamma, may there arise moral dhamma by the root condition. It is composed of the following four great Patana division.Positive, negative, positive, negative, negative, positive. This is four great Patana. Positive Patana division. Well, both the condition and conditioned Dhamma are related positive by a certain condition. As example,Depending on moral dhamma, may there arise a moral dhamma by root condition. The Pali, Siya Kusala Dhammam Badecha, Kusala Dhamma Obicheya Hedu Bacheya. The Pali. By the meaning, depending on moral dhamma, may there arise moral dhamma by root condition, etc.The negative Patana division, Paccaya, Paccaniya Patana. Where the both the condition and the conditioned Dhamma are related not by a certain condition. For example, dependent on moral Dhamma,May there arise more dhamma not by root condition. The Pali, Siya Kusalan Dhammam Badecha Kusala Dhamma Obicheya Na Hetu Paccaya. The positive negative Patana division, where the conditioning Dhamma and the conditioned Dhamma is related positively by a condition, but not by another condition. As example, depending on moral dharma, may there arise moral dharma by root condition, but not by object condition, aramana. Siya, kusalan dhamman badecha, kusalo dhammo, obecheya hetu bacheya, na aramana bacheya. The negative positive patana division. Where the conditioned dhamma in the conditioned dhamma are related not by a certain condition, but is related positively by another condition. For example, dependent on moral dhamma, may there arise moral dhamma, not by root condition, but by object condition. Siya kusalandama bateja kusalodamo obijeya na hedu bacheya aramana bacheya.
接下去呢，尊者为我们开始介绍这个大分的内容。这个大分一开始呢，在就巴利里面就首先呢有一个问题，从问题开始，就是说这个是源于三法，根据依于三法，源于三法呢，三法会以因缘而升起吗？就是三法能够让三法以因缘升起吗？这样的类似的问题呢，从这样来开始的。然后这整个大分呢，可以把它分成四个大的这个 patana 的这个部分。这四个 patana 部分呢，分别就是我们看到这个顺反以及反顺。那么第一个呢，顺的这个顺缘的 patana 就是 pachaya nuloma， 这个顺缘的这个呢，就是指呢，在缘法跟缘生法，就是因跟果之间呢，有一个正面的这个缘的关系。那比如说呢，它里面的刚才尊者有念这个，肯定有念这个巴利呢的意思，就是说缘与三法，其他的这个三法会以因缘而升起吗？所以这个是正面的，有没有因缘的这个情况。然后第二个呢，是指反的，反缘的。那这个反的呢是什么？就是在缘法跟缘生法之间，因跟果之间呢，是不存在着某一个缘的关系。那比如说呢，本地刚才念的这个巴利呢的意思就是说，缘与三法，三法会不以因缘而生起嘛，就是不以因缘，这个是否定的。所以刚才跟第一个呢是差别，这边是否定的。然后第三个呢，第三个内容呢就是顺跟反结合在一起的，就是指呢，就是说在缘法跟缘生法，因跟果之间呢，他们之间呢有一个正面的这个缘，也有呢否定的另外一个缘。那比如说呢，源于三法，三法会以因缘，但是不以所缘缘而生起嘛，就是它有因缘，但是没有所缘缘，所以这样的情况有一个顺的，也有一个反的。第四个呢，就是相反的，就是反顺呢，就是在缘法与缘生法之间呢，它有一个缘呢是不存在的，但是另外一个缘呢却是存在的。那比如说呢，源于三法，三法会不以因缘，但是以所缘缘而生起吗？那这个就是大分的四个主要的内容。
So the four great patana division, each great patana come out six patana. So triplet patana, triplet patana, cobra patana, cobra triplet patana,triplet copra patana, triplet patana, and so come out six copra patana. So one is you see coming out the six patana. So after that, also the triplet patana coming out another seven patana. Dependent connections.Conditioned, supported, enjoying, associated, investigation.
然后接下去我们可以看到这四个大的这个 patana 的这个分里面呢，每一个个别呢还有六个这个 patana 的部分。那我们看到这边的就是中间的那一栏， 这个呢，每一个都会有这六个分类。那六个分类是什么呢？就是第一个呢是根据善法的，善法巴达那，然后第二个呢是恶法巴达那，然后接下去是把它们集合在一起的恶法善法，然后是第四个是善法恶法，然后第五个是善法善法，第六个呢是恶法恶法，所以他们有这六种这个分类。然后这每一个巴达那分类，比如说这个善法的分类呢，又有七个章节。那这个章节分别就是缘与分第一个，然后是具身分，然后是缘意，然后是意指，然后是结合，然后相应，以及最后的这个问分。
Starting with the root corporate Hedu, that comprises 10 corporate patanas. So you think Tika patana is a bigger 20, so you can see the chest. Duga patana is a 100. Duga Tika patana begins 6,700. Tika Duga patana 4,400. Tika Tika patana 1,386. Duga Duga Patana 19,800. So totally 32,308. This is only one great patana. So you see the great patana division consists of 30,308. Multiplying four great patana. How many got? 129,222 patana session. This is only one chapter.
接下去要看这个，根据这样的分类呢，所以我们可以看得到啊，巴达那是非常的内容庞大繁杂的。那我们就比如说，根据刚才的那六类，从迪卡巴达那就是三分巴达那里面呢，因为有22组的这个三分法，所以有22种巴达那。然后第二个的二分巴达那呢，因为有100组的二分法，所以有100组。然后二分跟三分的结合起来呢，就会产生6600组的这样的一个巴达那。三分二分呢会产生4400，三分跟三分的结合呢有1386，然后二分跟二分的这个结合呢会有19800种巴达那，所以总共加起来呢，单单只是其中一个巴达那的大的这个部分呢，就会有32308个这样的巴达那。然后如果我们把所有四个这个大分都总合起来的话呢，就会有129232。
So I have detail, but if I talk here, it will become boring. So later I will give to Sister Palin, so he will share. So there is a, you can learn how to copy this one. So now we're going on. So from the structure of the Patana state above, Patana is a very profound subtle and very difficult to understand. Nothing in the universe is left out in the exposition of Patana by the infinite omission of the Buddha, law of Buddha. It is pointed out that when the omission Buddha contemplated himself on the seven book of Abhidhamma. So his imitated race only when he contemplated Patana. According to the method of the commentary, even the question chapter of Patana alone comprises a total of 448,533,248 questions. That is a passing well compatible capable of reciting 100,000 questions a day. He would take more than 10,000 years to complete the recitation. It is such that if the whole Batana is dictated, so there will be not enough paper for publication.
那智者说呢，之前呢提到的这个计算的方法呢，怎么去计算到的种种的上面提到的这些的多少个 batana 呢？因为这边如果跟大家讲述的，可能大家会觉得很繁琐，所以因此呢，智者会将这些资料呢，交给慧琳贤友跟大家分享，大家可以课后呢去学习如何去计算。那接下去呢，智者说呢，我们可以通过这样学习这个 batana。Batana 的结构可以很清楚的看得到呢， Batana 是非常深奥微妙很难懂的，因为佛陀以他这个没有止境的一切自知的这个智慧呢，没有遗漏了任何宇宙中的任何一样东西呢，全部都包含在这个 Batana 的阐述里面。那当时尊者说呢，根据依注的这个方法来看呢，只是 Batana 这个问题的章节，就是把问题提出来而已呢，总共呢就是有大家可以看到这边的这个4,049,4,853,3,248个问题，所以是只是单单问题而已，就这么多了。那即使有一个人他可以每一天可以念诵100,000个问题，也需要超过10,000年的时间才能够将问题全部能够背诵完毕。那而且呢也有说，如果我们在整个 Batana 呢把它详细的这个把它要印刷出来的话呢，在这个整个世界上呢，我们也找不到足够的纸张可以把整部 Batana 完整的印出来。
Why Buddha not teaching directly in the human world? The human not enough times. That's why the Buddha went to the Dawinta. So the Buddha teaching there, daytime he made the imagine the Buddha. After that, he came down to the human realm for Paintabat. Then he determination. So which path to which path you must teach into the Deva. So that's imagine Buddha continued. But many Deva don't know this is not really Buddha. The Buddha Quran, only the very higher Deva in Brahma they know. Or Buddha now going down to the human realm and take the Paintabhata. The Deva no need to eat. The Buddha's human body also can need to eat. So after he finished his lunch, so the Venerable Sariputra going to wait in Anuttara lake. There is a Buddha teach to the Venerable Sariputra. Venerable Sariputra, Buddha shaped to his 500 disciples. Their past life is all a night path. So the Buddha, the Venerable Sariputra teaching to them is the Batana suppressed in the human realm.
Now, 为什么佛陀没有在人间直接教这个阿毗达摩呢？那现在我们就可以理解到，因为阿毗达摩的非常的这个内容繁多，所以呢，在人间呢，人类没有这样的时间呢，可以听到这个完整的阿毗达摩教法。因此呢，佛陀就选择在天上在33天教导这个阿毗达摩的教法。而且呢，在白天的时候呢，佛陀就会变现一个化身佛，来在33天呢，然后决意让这个化身佛在天上呢继续教导什么到什么这样的内容的阿毗达摩，然后呢佛陀的人生呢就需要到天到人间来去托钵去进食。那很多呢天上的天人呢，他们也不知道原来呢跟他们说法的当时呢不是真正的佛陀，而是一个化身佛，只有那些非常高等的天人才可以知道。那虽然天人不需要可是呢佛陀当时呢因为是人的身体呢还是需要去进食的，所以因此呢他就需要这样的安排到人间来托钵进食。在佛陀托钵之后食用完毕的时候呢沙利子尊者呢舍利佛尊者呢就会在 这个阿诺塔塔湖就是无热恼湖旁呢，在等待着佛陀。然后佛陀就为沙利子尊者简单的教导他在天上教导的阿毗达摩的内容。然后沙利子尊者呢，在为他的250位弟子，这些弟子呢，过去世呢都曾经是蝙蝠，曾经听过这个教法呢，他们去学习沙利子尊者为他们讲解了这个阿毗达摩的教法，也就是现在呢流传下来的这个阿毗达摩的教法。
Now only the Pali text, you can find only 5 books, not all the day. Some are same, not put inside. That's why we can read the 5 books. In Myanmar, many monasteries, every summer season, they recite in Batana about 5 books need to 3 days or 4 days. So continuously, changing the bandi. Some are the half an hour, some are 1 hour, like this. So continuously, whole night, whole day, non-stop, is a need to at least 3 days, more than 3 days. So most of the 2, 5 days or 7 days. Sometimes they chanting all the 7 bitama. This one need to 1 week or 10 days.
尊者说，现在我们看到的这个 Batana 的这个巴利原文呢，现在呢只是集合成了只有5本书而已。那因为呢很多呢类似的内容呢，还有一些内容呢都被省略掉了，所以因此呢，现在呢这个 Batana 的这个巴利的这个原点呢就只有5本书，所以因此呢我们可以读这5本书。在缅甸呢有许多的寺院呢，他们特别在这个雨安居的期间呢。他们就会去念诵这个巴丹娜，这五本的这个巴丹娜呢，连续的念诵下去，就是没有间断的一个比库，另外一个比库这样一直连接的念诵下去，可能是每半小时或者每一个小时换另外一位比库在念，日夜昼夜不停的一直持续的念诵，这样呢要超过3天，可能要5到7天。那有些寺院甚至呢不只是念诵巴丹娜，还把所有7部阿毗达摩都念。那就可能需要一个星期或者是10天的时间才可以完全的把这整部阿毗达摩念完。
You see here? So if you recite 10,000 questions a day, how many years you need? 10,000 years will complete. We are like it's only maybe about 75, 80, not more than 100, so cannot finish.
那这里我们可以看到，如果呢一个人即使他有能力可以一天念诵10万个问题，那呢他要需要多久的时间呢？也要超过10,000年才可以念诵完毕。可是我们现在人的生命呢，就可能只有75岁到80岁，也不会超过100岁，所以呢是不可能有能力可以念诵完毕的。
Okay, today we learned the bridge chapter, under the bridge chapter, enumeration of the condition, Pichayog Desa Vara Pali. So first is some already know, Hedu Pachayo, Aramana Pachayo, Adibadi Pachayo, Anandara Pachayo, Sama Anandara Pachayo, Saha Jada Bachayo, Enya Menya Bachayo, Naysaya Bachayo, Uba Naysaya Bachayo, Buri Jada Bachayo, Bacha Jada Bachayo, Asewana Bachayo, Kama Bachayo, Vibhaga Bachayo, Ahara Bachayo, Indriya Bachayo, Jhana Bachayo, Mega Bachayo, Sambayota Bachayo, Vipayota Bachayo, Ati Bachayo, Nati Bachayo, Vigata Bachayo, Avigata Bachayo.
那尊者说呢，今天晚上呢，我们首先先来学习的就是这个属于略分里面的这个圆总说的内容。那圆总说的内容就是这24种缘，那它分别呢就是因缘、所缘缘、正上缘、无间缘、等无间缘、俱生缘、 相互缘、义子缘、庆义。Sandy, please next slide, please Sandy. 庆义子缘、前生缘、后生缘、重复缘、业缘、果报缘、时缘，还有根缘，然后以及最后的这个是禅那缘、道缘、相应缘、不相应缘、有缘、无有缘、离去缘以及不离去缘，24种缘。
So now we recite in this 24 Vatana.
尊者说，请我们大家现在一起。
All together, maybe can chant it, yeah? Hedu bacheyo aramana bacheyo adibadi bacheyo anandara bacheyo samanandara bacheyo sahajada bacheyo enyamenya bacheyo neseya bacheyo ubaneseya bacheyo purichada bacheyo bachachada bacheyo asewana bacheyoKamma bacheyo, vibhaga bacheyo, ahara bacheyo, indriya bacheyo, jhana bacheyo, megha bacheyo, samyoda bacheyo, vibhyoda bacheyo, ati bacheyo, nati bacheyo, vigeda bacheyo, avigeda bacheyo, di. One more time.After that, we call sadhu. Hedu bacheyo, aramana bacheyo, adibadi bacheyo, anandara bacheyo, samanandara bacheyo, sahajada bacheyo, enyamenya bacheyo, neseya bacheyo,Ubaneseya bacheyo, purichada bacheyo, bachachada bacheyo, asewana bacheyo, kamma bacheyo, vibhaga bacheyo, ahara bacheyo, indriya bacheyo, jhana bacheyo, megha bacheyo, samyoda bacheyo, vibhyoda bacheyoAti bacheyo, nati bacheyo, vigeda bacheyo, avigeda bacheyo, di. Ya sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. So, enough for today. So next day we start in analyzing care. And not next day, next week. analyzing care is procession.Of condition, no? Pichaya Nidisa.
尊者说呢，今天的教导呢就到这里为止呢，然后下一个星期呢再继续教导这个圆广说的内容。
Okay, we share all our merit to all the beings, all the who is already passed away, your Baba Mama, relative, or all the friends, or all relatives also, all the pita. So together, idhamme bonya, idhamme nyadina hotu, sukhita hondu nyadayo, idhamme nyadina hotu, sukhita hondu nyadayo, idhamme nyadina hotu, sukhita hondu nyadayo,Idhamme bhonyan asavakheya vahan hotu. Idhamme bhonyan nibbana sa bacheyo hotu. Mama bhonya vagan sabha sadhana bachemi. Te sabbe me samam bhonya vagan labantu. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.Sukhi hotu, may we attain Nibbana very soon.